know that there are a number of ways that cancer cells can become resistant to therapy. And these days, we actually think about the genetics or the genes within the cells as very, very important aspects of this. But there's an untold story, and that is how these cells actually crosstalk amongst each other within a tumor. And part of this has to do as to how much oxygen is in the tumor. And we now know if there's low oxygen, this crosstalk becomes quite aggressive and the cancer cells become aggressive. And low oxygen is called hypoxia.
Tumor cells, when they lack oxygen, turn out to be extremely resistant to therapy and develop characteristics of aggressive disease. And patients with these types of tumors do poorly, and we're aimed at trying to change that by developing and testing new therapies for those particular types of patients. One of the real strengths of the Terry Fox Research Institute is their vision to fund research teams and team science. And it enables us to do research that's really not possible in individual labs. We have co-leads that bring expertise in basic biology and fundamental biology, and that's myself, as well as expertise from the clinic and clinician scientists, and that's the part that Dr. Bristow brings to the team. And so the two of us, by having a sort of co-directorship, allows us to ensure that our program remains balanced, remain focused on both parts of these programs, this pipeline from very basic science to implementation and care, gets a lot of attention because of the individual expertises of the two of us.
Our program has been running since 1996 and was originally headed by a scientist named Richard Hill. And what Dr. Hill said was, hey, let's look at the oxygen levels in tumors and see whether or not they actually predict how patients respond. So for the first era of our project, it was how do we measure oxygen levels in tumors and how do we show that actually it's important for patients and how they respond to therapy. In the new era, now that I co-lead the program with Dr. Wouters, we're asking, in fact, not to measure oxygen, but what is the function of oxygen? How is the oxygen changing the genes or the actual chromosome structure within the tumors? Some of the key goals or milestones of our particular project is to, one, actually be able to measure the level of oxygen in tumors as treatment is actually taking place. We want to know whether resistance is developing early or not, and therefore intervene much earlier and actually prevent resistance and improve cure. So one of those milestones is actually develop technologies to do that within the first 2 years. In the third, fourth, and fifth years, we want to see the clinical trials that are based on this information actually giving us results and giving us a new direction about what type of novel treatments are going to be most effective for patients who are resistant to therapy because of low oxygen, hypoxia, but also because of this marriage between hypoxia and the genetics of the tumor.
The Terry Fox Research Institute project that we are leading is focused primarily on three cancer types: prostate cancer, cervix cancer, and head and neck cancer. And these are cancers where there's extremely strong evidence that tumor hypoxia influences the curative potential of those therapies. Patients coming in expecting a cure for their tumors, we know that hypoxia is limiting that cure. And so we recognize that it's an enormous opportunity for actually changing the potential for cure in those patients. Individuals, when they come in, even when they have tumors that look very similar down a microscope, harbor fundamental differences in the genetic makeup of those tumor cells and in the environment in which those tumor cells grow. And so individual patients don't have the same response to therapy. And our previous approach is to one therapy for all patients benefits some, but it leaves other patients with therapies that are suboptimal. And what we're trying to do now is to categorize those patients into different types of groupings, patients that can benefit from specific types of therapy, and in order to give the right treatment to the right patient at the right time to maximize everyone's chance for effective therapy.